Hey guys, welcome back to Thin Place Factorio, and this is the build, current build, 14.21, for anyone is interested in that. So I'm going to start a new game. I finished the campaign, the New Hope campaign. Now I try to apply what I learned. So you know, normal, everything normal, generate, and this will be an episodical, where in each episode I do a specific task, or in the beginning anyway, simple setups. For example, in the first episode, we will just do the basic setup for coal and iron, so we will produce iron. So, and again, I'm not by any means a specialist, a professional, or whatever you want to call it. I'm just a guy who likes to play. I like to play the game. Anyway, okay, I just want to, make a nice episode from beginner to beginner, so to speak. So let's see. We start here with, as you can see on the map, we have coal, iron, stone, water, and copper. Then we have oil. Okay, that's the resources we have in this game. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 resources, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yes. That's the 5 resources we have. With and water, it's another resource, actually. It's used as well. So, and trees, of course. So, wood. So, let's see here. What we need is... we need steel, iron plates. So we're gonna start here with this is the burner mining drill. A burner mining drill will use fuel like wood, coal, wood and coal. I don't think we can connect it to electricity. I don't know, not actually. We did planks, it means fuel, so not electricity. I don't know if it can use oil, for example, or fuel or something. I don't know. But I know it can use coal and wood. Now, iron, the iron ore. The first thing you do in the game is you make yourself an iron axe, because you see the difference now. So, iron ore in this form is not is useless. For anything, it's not used for anything. This is the result you want, and this you get by melting. So you have a now here, the burning mining drill has the, you see this is the output. If you put on the overlay with Alt, click Alt, you will see this is the output. If you don't put anything here, it will output one unit of whatever it mines, for example, ore, outputs it here, and then stop. You can now do this as a furnace, so now the output will enter the furnace. Both of course need fuel, and this is stone. We're gonna need some stone later on, so. Now we're gonna cut, it's easier to cut trees for fuel, because each tree gives you 4 wood. So it's a lot easier to get. A little trick, if you keep right clicking, just hold right click all the time, and then when you move, as soon as you move over to a harvesting resource, for example, I still have right click clicked on. As you can see, I will keep harvesting. However, still right click, still hold. Normally it should not. No, it does. Okay, right click, hold, it just does whatever right click does. Okay, so now we can put fuel here and here. Okay, now this will produce iron plates. Okay, so what do we need next? Okay, so we need more of these. So we need more iron, of course. First of all, we're gonna make another furnace. It's you can see here we have a we put another furnace here. Let's see you in a second. I'm gonna get some more wood. Again, I'm not doing this by any means optimized or whatever. It's just I do stuff just do stuff as I feel fit. Maybe sometimes I take it a bit longer. Maybe I don't do this. Sometimes not the perfect way, but I'm more the kind of hey, it works. So as long as it works, that's fine. So let's see here if you have a click. What I did was I clicked Control and then left, and you will pick up whatever you click on. If you have something, for example, if in this case, for example, I add this to my list here. If I click like so, nothing will happen. I will open. If I left click here, it will open the interface. If I control left click, then I will drop whatever I have in the on the cursor onto the object below. So let's see. Now you can hear we can burn two burner grills and one of these. So now we can add this. don't worry that there is not full resource down here. There still have 1900, 2800, so clean up everything nicely. Now I'm gonna go over here, and as you can see, we have a lot of coal down here. So the next thing we're going to do is, well, first of all, I'm going to get some wood, and then to make the burners work, and then we're going to harvest the coal. Harvest mine the coal. It's mining coal, yes, coal mine, of course. I say harvest because harvest is usually something that is on the ground while mining is below the ground, and in this game I mean the minerals, the ore and everything, it's shown on the ground, but I try to think of it that it's in the ground below and it just shows above, so you know where it is anyway. So some of these. Add some of these here. There you go. So now we're going to make a couple of let's make a couple of here for a few here. Now there's a little trick now here. Actually, I want to do something here. A little trick with the coal here is that let's see if I can pull this off. Okay, let's start down here. Okay, like so. Now I'll show you why. As you can see, the output of each coal here goes to the next one. So let's see. I'm just going to put something here. Now let's see what happens. It outputs coal to the next one. This one outputs the coal to the next one. Outputs the coal to the next one. So basically you have a daisy chain of four drills that will output at the end here. Of course you can arrange this however you want. So you can basically chain everything together. Okay, actually, that's what I'm going to do. I guess you could do something like this. Like so. Okay. So you put the coal here, and then you go tuck, tuck, tuck down. So you can basically chain the whole thing together. And then at the end, you put a little chest like so, here. Right here. Now the coal gets inside the wooden chest. once it goes through here, to this system here. Okay? As you can see, this works just fine. Yeah, but you need, of course, for example, can take all the coal here and put it in the first one, so you know that there's enough coal for the whole chain. So now this is going, and then we have the steel production over there. Nice. Actually, we're gonna need some steel here, so we're gonna put this here. As you can see, we have a lot of plates now, a lot of iron plates. So let's see. I need some stone. Stone is up here. Ah, yeah, we can build a stone furnace. I'll show you what I mean. There, yes, you can see the stone, sometimes it's a bit hidden. I'm gonna put this here. So let's see, we're gonna put where do I need the stone furnace? Ah, yeah, I need actually stone. Of course. So, 2, 3, 4. There you go. Build it by the dry nail. Okay. We destroyed our axe. So, gonna place it here and add some fuel. Now, I don't want to run over there all the time, so. No, actually, not. Doesn't matter. Just fill up this with stones. I need some more. Let me the second one. With a chest in front of it. Get some fuel. There you go. There you go. So now we have a couple of stone here. And as you can see, we have a lot of plates now. We're gonna actually do something here. Yeah, let's add two more drills, which we add here and here, so we clean this up here right away. Okay, now let's go down here to take the coal. You can see this working nicely. So need some more. Can do like this, click, click, click. As you can see, it will fill them up to 50 before they're delivering here. Only this one delivers to here, the rest goes, it will fill up 50 here, 50 here, 50 here, and then it will start to deliver here. The surplus. So that's why there wasn't so much. Let's see here. Gotta fill this up with coal. There you go. That gives us a lot of iron. So now, it's going to be the center of our base here. We're going to do some work here. Let's see. We're going to make here our main iron line. This will fill with iron. We'll fill with iron. This is just for now. This is not a permanent structure of any kind. It's just so we have something to regulate ourselves with. No fuel. There you go. Actually, going to change this here. I want to automate the production of iron plates, okay? So how we do this? Let me see. It's going to be the goal of this episode. So right now I have enough iron plates to do this. So I'm gonna remove the furnaces. And actually, the reason is I want the furnace to be automatically filled with iron and coal. Okay, so what we're going to do is, since the coal is down here, we're going to move the iron like this, somewhere down here. Okay, and then we bring it down here. Okay. Now we could send it like this, but now look what we do now. There's an important thing with the belts to know, is that they have two sides, and the two sides they can move independently, meaning the belt will always run even if it's full, and if there's something on the other side, it will also run even if the other side is full. So as you can see now, all the iron gets on the left side of the belt. Left, depending on the top side, if you want to. So now we bring this belt up. The transport belt up. And then you see it stays on the left side. Now, we have the coal here. We bring the coal up here. And then on the belt like this. And look what happens now. The coal stays on the right side, and this is the whole reason we do this. Now, another thing we want to do here is I want this to automatically fill itself. As you can see now, this is not very effective because it will fill up. I mean, it will eventually be effective, but it's not as effective as it could be. So what we're going to do is, we're going to, like this, you want to do it like this, here, gonna build this here, I don't know if we need 5 or if 1 is 4 is enough, but I got 5 anyway, and you go here, we add this to this line here. And then this one, and now, here. Now, I don't want to bother, these are burner drills who burn coal to mine coal, so And these ones are inserters. Inserters that pick something up from the where the arrow is. No, they pick something up where the line is. For example, if I put it here, it will pick up whatever is on the transporter belt and drop it here. And they work with burner inserters, work with burns fuel for energy. So it burns coal. So since here it picks up coal from the coal drill to deliver coal, it will take coal for itself to burn energy and then use it. So what we're going to do is not like this. We're going to add, first of all, we're going to make it clearer here. The delivery of coal happens like this, okay? Coal gets dropped on the belt, it gets here, and then it gets assembled with the iron. So now in order to this for them to be self-sufficient, we add the inserters like so. Now, never happened. Let's see. We're just going to, just to make a point here. We add one coal here. Now let's see what happens. The first coal gets delivered. Because one coal is enough for several mining processes. So, as you can see now, this inserter here will insert the coal into this one here. And eventually it will say, okay, now you can deliver to the next one, to the next one, to the next one. Now, of course, we're going to hurry this up a little bit but this will produce coal infinity until the coal below it has gone. As you can see now, it lets coal pass through because I think it wants 5 at best, most. So we're gonna put some coal in it anyway, just so it can it doesn't wait too long. As you can see now, we have this 5 burner drills collecting coal here. So now we have coal. It's going up here. So now we can make our furnaces. Now we need some more furnaces. We're gonna make 8 furnaces for now. As you can see now like this. And now the inserters again they can pick up they can both this is one unit. So this here will pick up the iron ore and the coal, and they will pick up the coal for themselves so they get fueled. So we add this like this. There we go. Now we need an output, because otherwise they will just keep it inside themselves. So as you can see now, they will fuel yeah, it's perfect. It's just perfect. So, now we need an output, which you can put in any sense you want. I mean, it doesn't matter. You can go down here into a chest or up there and then use it elsewhere. For now, I'm going to put it downwards, like so. And simply because I don't want it to go anywhere right now. And once I want it to go anywhere else, we can then produce below ground belts, which then will remove this anyway to make it a little look a bit more proper. So we're going to add this here. Now this insert is here gonna need fuel because they don't have any access to coal. So what we could do actually, good question. No, as long we cannot do anything right now, because we don't have a filter. We can't filter it out, so just gonna pick up the coal here. Pick up the coal from here. And then answer them here. And then, of course, I'll make a proper chest here. So now we have here our iron. So we have an iron plate production here. Simple, efficient. But of course, this is just a beginning of the whole process. In the next episode, we will... So this is just a resume. We made a basic iron plate production. A good iron plate production. It's working very well. What it does anyway. It's going to be filled up soon, but that's okay. Yeah, in the next episode, we'll go electric, which means we're going to electrify our whole system, get away from the coal. We're still going to burn coal in the furnaces here, but we will build ourselves steam engines or whatever. So we're going to mine some... from the copper. We'll add a copper mining access, and then I wonder if I should do this now. Yeah, I think we need to mine some copper. I think that's probably a good idea to do this right now, seeing as the copper is so far down there. So let's see here. Gonna pick up the stone here. That's way than enough. Don't need to fuel them anymore. Not for now, anyway. Later on, you need, but not now. So, we're going to build five of these. Okay. So, we're going down here. We're going down here. I should have picked up some more. That doesn't matter. Anyway. Okay. I'm gonna bring this all up. There we go. Again, you don't have to do it like this, but I like having stuff delivered right away to where I am. I say it's like this. It's like it's a little investment right now, but in the end, it will. Make a lot, you have to make it a lot less running around. So, So we need some more steel. I know. There you go. I think I'm gonna put a coal here into a box so it can pick up some surplus. Actually, you're gonna surplus the shit out of the hell of it, sorry. let's see what I mean. Gonna add some more drills. There you go. Now you want to put them like this. There you go. You have to insert this going like this, of course. I want to really overproduce the coal as much as possible, because you're going to need a lot. And since this setup is this setup is self-sufficient here, this one here. It really doesn't matter, you can construct all here, build one line up, and then, I mean, if it's too much, it will stop harvesting, it doesn't cost anything. So, that's something you might want to do. So you have a major input of coal. So let's see, we have 164 coal here, we have some steel. Okay. I'm gonna add this. I'm gonna fuel this down here. So we'll get some copper production going on. There we go. Now we have copper coming up here. And again, this isn't necessary, absolutely, but I like this to be automated, so I don't have to bother with it. The copper is the same thing as with the iron. The copper itself is useless. It's only used once you have you transform it into bars. So as here as well, we're going to do is we're going to add a furnace here. Let's see. Guess it's this episode. And like so. So, keep this going. We're gonna add. I know, there's something wrong here. What's going on here? And we want the copper on the other side, okay? Like here, we want the copper on the inside. So, what we're going to do is simple trick, like so. There you go. Now the copper goes on the inside. Move this here, the copper over here. Now if you want to re-insert something into a line, just add a box like this. The inserter will always put it on the far side. So if you put the inserter here, it will put it on the side where the ore is right now, as you can see. So now, to add some coal here, of course, we're going to add the coal. It will, and as you can see now, we have copper left and coal right on the inserter. So we're gonna add a couple of burners. Let's make 8, like on the top. Let's see, one step close. There you go. 4, 8, okay. And then one to deliver upwards the iron, the copper bars, or plates, copper plates. There you go. There we go. Now it's a couple of inserters. 16 to be exact, but we need more iron. Okay. 5, 10, 15, 16. Left click is producing 1, right click is producing 5, and shift left click is producing everything you can. Okay, so I'm gonna give this here and then exit here. Okay, now we need some coal. To fuel them. Why isn't this picking up something? I don't know. There you go. So there we go. Now we have a production of. I can remove this one, but not the other one. So now we have a production of plates. We need to. Okay, we need to. Forgot this here. Of course, we would like to also have them harvested somewhere. I need copper. There you go. As you can see now, iron and copper mined. And that's the basic setup. I have always the two major resources, three major resources, plus coal, plus iron bars, iron plates, and copper plates, which are used for pretty much everything else in the game, unless until you discover plastics. So, yes, so this is the first episode, the basics, basic setup to. And again, this is by no means optimized or whatever. There is no. I have not consulted or calculated any ratios or optimized or whatever. I don't care about it. For me, I like the approach more of I build, and when I see that something is overproducing, then I will compensate by either reducing the output or improving the input. I mean the output, if, for example, I have too much here, I have too much iron produced, which isn't probably not true in itself, because here the problem here is the bottleneck is not the furnaces, is not the delivery or whatever. The bottleneck would be this here, the inserter. This inserter is like one. It's very slow. It doesn't have to be faster right now, but it would be stupid for me to say okay. For example, in this case, I won't go and say, okay, we have all this iron here, so what are we going to do? Hey, let's double the furnaces. Let's add another line of furnaces here. And then think, okay, this should work now. No, it won't work, because the output is still limited here. So later on, I will switch this to a fast inserter. And then, later on, you will use this line directly to go wherever it needs to be to produce stuff, and then this thing will look better, and then you can decide if you want to add some furnaces or add drills or add coal or whatever. But I don't want to go and say okay, so the ratio is it needs 4 drills for each 2 furnaces for each 2 coal mines and this and that. That's boring me. That's not why I do this. I want to play a game. I want to discover stuff, and I want to fix problems. I like to fix problems on the fly, the run into problems and then find the solution to the problem. So this here is everything I made here is it's the second free game I play. I played just the campaign and one free game where I learned stuff. And this is so my first time I really played this properly, I guess. And nothing here was premeditated, nothing here was calculated, nothing here is in any kind of shape really prepared. So stay with me and discover the game together with me, and we learn how to play. So next episode we're going to electrify. So thanks for watching, and see ya.